الله سبحانه وتعالى سيدنا القرآن: ولقد بعثنا في كل أمة رسولا أن اعبدوا الله واجتنبوا الطاغوت. And we have sent to every nation a messenger that you worship Allah and stay away from idolatry. The messenger sent to the Arabs was Ibrahim. The deen of Ibrahim, the religion of Ibrahim, was preached in the peninsula of Arabia via his son Ismail alayhi salam. And thus Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeatedly says in the Quran, Millat Abi Ibrahim. This is the religion of your father Ibrahim. Islam is not a religion that has started even in the Arabian Peninsula, leave aside the world, by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Islam is the religion of Ibrahim. And thousands of years before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Arabs were upon the religion of Ibrahim. There was the Sharia of Ibrahim that existed among the Arabs. Kaaba was built by Ibrahim in Makkah. Makkah was designated sacred by Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Makkah was designated Haram, means sanctuary. No one was to be killed once he enters Makkah. Hunting was prohibited inside the premise of Makkah. You cannot harm a plant inside Makkah. A person would see the murderer of his father in Makkah, but wouldn't touch him. Ibrahim alayhi salam designated the four sacred months. The four sacred months when fighting is prohibited, the 1st, the 7th, the 11th, the 12th month of the year, was and still is haram. Means any type of battle in these months are prohibited. That's Muharram, Rajab, Dhul-Qadha and Dhul-Hijjah. Ibrahim alayhi salam instituted Hajj along with all its rituals. Now, if Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam were upon Tawheed, monotheism, then when and where did paganism come about in Arabia? In Mecca? That's a valid question. If at the time of Ibrahim and Ismail, the Arabs were by and large upon Tawheed, upon monotheism, and at the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, these Arabs were almost all upon paganism. There were more than 360 idols in and around Kaaba. So the valid question is, how and when did these monotheists become pagans and idolaters? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replies to this in a hadith from Sahih Muslim 2856. He says, I saw Amr bin Luhay al-Khuza'i wandering around in the fire of hell with his insides cut out behind him. He was the first to change the deen of Ismail. So we have a historical fact coming right from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Idolatry was brought in Arabia from this person called Amr bin Luhay from the tribe of Khuza'. Now the books of Sirah narrates the whole story that Amr bin Luhay traveled to Syria where there were the Amaliq. Old Testament calls them Amalekites. Amaliq, Amalekites. An ancient civilization. Amr bin Luhay, when visited the Amalekites, he found them worshipping the idols and he found them to be a powerful civilization. He said, what are these idols? They said, these are our sources of power. When we are hungry, when we are attacked, we pray to these idols and miracles happen. Amr bin Luhay asked him, can you give him one of such idols? So the Amalekites, the Amaliq, gave him an idol called Hubal. So Hubal became the first idol brought to the Arabian Peninsula, and it also remained to be the main idol up until the time of Nabuwah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this man, Amr bin Luhay, brought idolatry to the Arab. Now who is Amr bin Luhay? If you remember from our past video, we discussed that Arabs were the descendants of Qahtan, and they are called Qahtani Arab, the pure Arabs. But then Ismail alayhi salam came and settled in Makkah. One of the Qahtani tribes, the tribe of Jurhum, settled in Makkah with Ismail alayhi salam. And Ismail alayhi salam married into the tribe of Jurhum. A new blend of outsiders, Ismail alayhi salam, and the Qahtani Arab formulated. And from this blend, 7 to 10 generations below, a man called Adnan came. And after his name, this blend lineage is called Adnani Arabs. The Arabized Arabs, Arabs who became Arabs later on, they were called Adnani Arab. So this blend of Adnani tribe and Qahtani tribe of Jurhum, this tribe of Jurhum used to rule over Mecca, and they were the flag bearers of the Deen of Ibrahim. They controlled Mecca, and Kaaba was in Mecca. They controlled Zamzam. They controlled Safa and Marwa. They controlled the Hajj. So they were the flag bearers of the Deen of Ibrahim. Then a Qahtani tribe from outside, the tribe of Khuza', attacked on Mecca, lusting for the influence over all of Arabia by controlling the Kaaba. Amr bin Luhay al-Khuza'i was one of them, not just one of them, one of the chieftains of the tribe of Khuza'. And they happened to win over Mecca. Now it is possible that Amr bin Luhay might not be alive at the time the Banu Khuza', the tribe of Khuza', attacked Mecca. He might have come later on, he might have been a chieftain later on. But this Banu Khuza', after they controlled Mecca, every tribe from every corner of Arab used to come to pilgrimage for Hajj every year to Mecca. And these Banu Khuza' hardly understood what the essence and soul of Tawheed is. This Amr bin Luhay al-Khuza'i, he went to the Amalekites, brought this idol Hubal and kept it beside Kaaba. And every tribe from every corner of Arab is coming to visit the Kaaba, and they saw the leaders and chieftains of Mecca worshipping the idols. Slowly but shortly, whole of Arabia followed in their footsteps. Now, it is important that Amr bin Luhay didn't reject the already worshipped god of the Arabs. Rather, he introduced to them new idols. So that is why you will find the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the existence of the names like Abdullah means worshipper of Allah, and the names like Abd Manaf, worshipper of Manaf, side by side. A man would be worshipping Allah and a man would be worshipping Hubal and Allat al-Uzza and Manaf together. Now a final question, when was Amr bin Luhay born? We cannot truly say exactly. We cannot give an exact date or year because the Arabs didn't have a proper calendar. So not having a proper calendar, they didn't preserve dates well at all. But one thing Arabs preserved very well, and that thing is genealogy. Any famous person's name you get from the Arab, you are gonna know for certain who his father was, and who his father was, and who his father was, all the way till another famous person appears in the list of genealogy. We are gonna hear the reference to genealogy back and again in the seerah, because Arabs were specialists of genealogy. So be familiar with this term. Now if we look at the genealogy of Amr bin Luhay, we can understand what generation he belonged to, and we find out he was born roughly in the same generation of Fihr, who was the founder of Quraysh tribe. Means we can calculate Amr bin Luhay was 11 generations before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which coincides roughly with 1st to 2nd century of the Christian era. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born in the 6th century. So the introduction of Hubal and idolatry in Arabia by Amr bin Luhay is only 4 to 500 years old. Even at the time of Isa, the Arabs were by and large at Tawheed. Now, our next topic is lineage of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But I have already made videos about life of Hashim, the great grandfather of Prophet, life of Abdul Muttalib, the grandfather of the Prophet, life of Abdullah, the father of the Prophet. So I will attach those older videos here in the playlist, you can watch them. And the next video I am going to make is directly delving into the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inshallah.